Una una, the best thing was there were 25,000 people there. One of the biggest, if not the biggest crowd at a boxing title fight, before sa Filipinas. Cebu had about 15 to 18,000 when Gores fought Fernando Montiel maybe 10 years ago in the same venue. But this time there were 25,000. In fact, yung mga American internet site says it was 30,000. But we leave it at 25,000 because that's the official figure given to me by Michael Aldegate, the president of Ala Promotions. That was one thing. Pangalawa, they were so enthusiastic and excited about the fights. And it started with the performance of Mark Magsayo, Magnifico. He was dropped by Chris Avalosa, outstanding American fighter. He was dropped in the end of the third round when he had command of the fight, but he came back in typical Filipino fashion, made a courageous comeback, and mauled Chris Avalos to win by a six-round TKO. In the case of Donaire, alam naman, I predicted 5 rounds. He didn't allow my prediction to come through. He stopped Bedak in 3 rounds. Kasi, he was too strong and too fast for Bedak. Bedak was a game fighter, game challenger. He fought as best as he could, but he was overwhelmed by the power and the speed of Donaire. Yung dalawang knockdown with the left hook, and then the third knockdown with the right, and then the left uppercuts, wasak ang mukha ni Bedak. He was bloodied nose, bloodied mouth. He had, I think, 12 stitches inside the mouth because it was so badly ripped apart. So it was a completely dominating performance by Nonito Donaire, as we all expected. He was just one class higher than Zolt Bedak. But you got to give Bedak credit for his gallantry. You know, Andonsia, he didn't run. He stood and fought, which is a good thing. That's what made the fight more exciting. But Donaire was just too good.
So, tingin niyo po sino po yung kakalabanin next ni Donaire?
Well, he has got some names in mind. One is Carl Frampton, the IBF champion. The other one is Hugo Ruiz, the WBC champion from Mexico. And then, of course, he mentions the name of Rigondeaux, Guillermo Rigondeaux, the one who beat him at the New York City Music Hall some years ago. But it will not be an attractive fight. Ako mismo sinabi ko sa kanya, forget Rigondeaux because he will hit and run. And the fans won't like that kind of fight. They want an action-packed fight. And Ruiz or Frampton will be really good fights. He'll have a hard time against Frampton because Frampton is a good fighter. He knocked out Carlos Rios in 7 or 8 rounds a couple of years ago. And he's a good fighter. He's a good fighter. He also knocked out Chris Avalos. Frampton knocked out Chris Avalos, I think 6 or 7 rounds in Britain. And he is a good fighter, good hard hitter, moves well. So Donaire is going to have to train very hard and prepare very, very well if he fights Frampton or even Hugo Ruiz of Mexico for their title.